Welcome back. We were just about to go to the final age in the Yisha's journey, content of the of Uru without the expansion packs. And as I told you in a previous video, it's actually two ages, but we have only one pillar left and only one linking book. So the second of this pair of ages we'll need to get to in another way. But there's no need to worry about that now. It will become evident by itself. Here we have arrived in one of the two ages. This is Eder Gira. We look around, we see that it's a very dry age. Looks like another desert. And there are these fumaroles, steam vents, indicate that this is also a volcanic age. Each of these fumaroles has a cover with a petal. We should know by now that that allows us to do something with it, and we can close these covers. There's a whole bunch of these steam vents around. The smaller ones don't have covers. Some plants here as well, and these things, I don't know, maybe they're plants, maybe they're something like Venus flytraps or something. It could be mushrooms as well, I suppose. I don't know, desert vegetation, it's not one of my areas of expertise. We look around more, we also see a journey cloth. It's very high. We climb this plant? No. We can get there some other way. From up here we can see there's a waterfall over there. So this age isn't totally bone dry. A red glow there, which seems to indicate lava. Yeah, there's definitely lava over there. So I was right about the volcanic part. Let's see if we can get to that journey cloth. It's all there's a ledge there. Can we jump? No. Well, we're gonna have to find another way to get there. Right now we can't reach that particular journey cloth. So let's look around a little bit more. Walk further up this way. See that these plants very thorny. Looks like you might be able to climb them, but you actually can't. So move over here. Some more vegetation and another fumarole. Well, let's close this one too. Interesting. Sort of a stone arch serves as a bridge here. There's another one of these vents in the middle of what appears to be a crevasse with lava at the bottom. And on the other side, there's a ledge with a journey cloth on it. I want to get to that journey cloth. And we've already been on the other side of this particular crevasse, so it shouldn't be hard to get there. I think I can jump this, yes. A little shortcut. Well, here's that ledge. So I can just walk onto it. Let's try not to fall down. And now we have our first journey cloth. How can I get out of here without falling into an untimely death in the lava? Well, there's that little platform with the fumarole on it. So let's see if I can jump over there. And I have to make this a standing jump, and damn, missed it. I know this is possible. That was obviously not the way. I'm gonna run into the lava. I don't remember if I've shown that before, but whenever you fall off anything or do anything that would might maybe get you killed, you will always automatically link back to Ralto. Okay, we have another book. Of course, which is the book for Eder Gira. Let's link back to that journey cloth. Let's try that jump again. I know it's possible. Oh, that's a bit... come on! Ah! This is annoying. I'm going to do this another way, because that particular jump isn't working out for me today. I know it's possible, I've done it before. But I'm just going to link back to the beginning now. Make the jump from there, instead of continuing to fail at that particular jump. Might be wondering why I'm trying to do that, since I've already got the journey cloth. Well, I need... Oh. Ah, come on! This isn't my day! I'm sorry for this. This is going to be one of the more interesting parts of this video. Just me failing over and over again at this particular jump. I need to close that fumarole, that's why I have to make this jump. I should be able to do it from here, if I stand a little bit further back. I'm gonna see that now I'm gonna fail at it from the other direction. Ah! Made it! At last! I don't know, I think actually, if you're standing this close to lava, wouldn't you pretty much catch fire because of the convection heat? Not in this game, apparently. I think in real life you would. Well, let's continue our exploration. It's the other side of the arch. From here we can see a waterfall, and there's some kind of space there with a book, a linking book there. Nice looking waterfall. Can we get there? Well, this is another insurmountable waist-high fence, so we can't get there this way. We need to find another way. Besides, we still need that journey cloth too. Over here is another couple of these fumaroles. And pretty low wall. It looks like I might be able to get over there, but not by jumping. Well, let's close these two fumaroles. You see now, they begin to rattle. That's because I've closed all but one of them. And the pressure is really high. You cannot close all of them. If you do, then they will all blast open because of the high pressure. and this is the only one left open, which is the one below that ledge with the journey cloth. And of course I didn't do that by accident, I did it on purpose. Now if I stand on the fumarole, I got blown up by the pressure, and I can reach the journey cloth. Again, wouldn't that steam be really, really hot? But apparently not. Okay, well, now that I've got the journey cloth, this is a good point to end this video. I will continue in the next video.